Hey gardeners, John from Horizon Hydroponics here, and today I want to talk about IPM, Integrated Pest Management. And basically, it's how many of those bad bugs can you deal with in your garden. First, in your garden, it's all about cleanliness. The cleaner you keep it, the easier it will be to identify and notice the bugs that may have infiltrated your sacred space. Second is identification. Knowing what you're dealing with is most important. That way, you know how to treat them. Third is life cycle. Once you know what bug it is, you want to read up and find out what its life cycle is and figure out what the best time to interrupt it will be. Fourth is pesticide selection. That sounds misleading because we may not use a pesticide at all. We may choose to use an essential oil, an enzyme, a bacteria, or a fungus at this time to battle our bugs. And fifth becomes frequency. How often do you need to treat with one of these products to interrupt the life cycle of the bug that you're trying to defeat? Let's take spider mites for example. Two spotted spider mites have a reproduction rate of 3 days. So we'll want to spray every 3 days on a 3 day cycle to interrupt their life cycle, preventing those eggs from hatching or the mothers from laying more eggs. Another way of controlling the spider mite population is with predatory bugs. Those are bugs that eat other bugs, so we don't have to even use a spray or an oil or anything else on our leaves. So in the end, IPM means living with a certain population of the bad bug that you don't like, but at a level that it's not damaging your crops, it's not damaging your quality, your output. Especially as the garden grows, it becomes more and more challenging to get to each individual plant and make sure that they're all 100% clean, but not using the nuclear option to try and destroy everything at once. Well, gardeners, if you have any other questions, hit us up online, horizonhydroponics.com, our Instagram, our Facebook. We're here to help you out.